I'm just gonna start out by drilling a few holes, checking the depths, and looking for fish. I'm in 38 feet of water right here. I'm making my way over to a weed bed. It drops off into about 17 to 20 feet of water. Hoping to pick up some big bluegill and some crappie today. Yeah, I got one that showed up underneath me about a foot. I'm starting off with a chandelier jig. It's a vertical jig, got treble hooks on the bottom, and it's made of tungsten. That'll allow me to get down to the depths faster than your basic lead would. You always want to check your drag. If you hook up with a big fish and it takes off on a big run, it's going to snap your line. If your drag's set properly, it'll be able to take off, and it'll take line off of your spool instead of snapping your line. So always check your drag, even throughout the day. Check it two or three times a day. Especially if you're fishing outside in the cold elements. I got one down there looking at it, but he just doesn't want to grab it. It's a little chilly out here this morning. Right around 1 degree, 0 degrees. My wax worms are already starting to freeze up. I'm gonna have to get them put away here somewhere. But I put a flutter spoon on there. Seems like everything likes a flutter spoon. Put two wax worms on the treble hooks. I had a fish down there for 10 to 15 minutes and he wasn't really showing any interest in the chandelier jig. So I'm gonna throw something on there that falls, that flutters down and kind of moves all over, see if I can't excite him to take a swipe at it. If not, I'm gonna move on to the next hole and drill a few more holes, make my way over to the weed bed, the weed line. Chandelier jig with the wax worms. Not a bad way to start out the morning. About a 2 pound bass. Pretty, pretty fish. I'm gonna let him go. I couldn't get my camera rolling fast enough. I just got the house set up. I'm in 16 feet of water off the edge of a weed bed. drops off from about 5 feet of water down to 20, then gradually into 30 plus feet of water. About a 2.5 pound bass. I'm gonna let this one go. Get back to it, we'll try to find some bluegills. I switched to a little pink and glow-in-the-dark grub jig, a little grub-shaped jig. Belly's glow, back's pink. Tipped it with a couple of wax worms. We'll see what happens. Something grabbed it right away. Won't let go. He's following, he's grabbing, just nibbling. There he is. Oh, just barely touching it. There it is. There, I got him. Snake Norman. About a 1 pounder. There you go, another one showed up on bottom. See if we can't get him to come up and nibble on our hook. There he is. Another largemouth bass. The bass are hungry, but a 1 pounder. Throw in a little chartreuse and white, little tiger stripes on there with the silver back. And I just put a couple impulse plastics on it. Give this a try, see if I can't get any fish's attention. Feels like we're hooked up with a norther. Big bass. Woo-hoo-hoo! Check out that bass right there. Dang. That's a chunky one there, guys. Check that out there. Look at that. Fist almost fits in there. Dang. I'd have to say that's about 4 pounds right there. Wow.
Hit on a little tube jig.
And it feels like another bass, and it is.
About a 1-pounder.
Not too shabby. Got those last two largemouth bass on a tube jig.
Well, panfish tube jig, that is. Tipped with the wax worm.
Got a fish on. Feels like a northern. And this little guy.
About a pound, pound and a half maybe.
Guessing you got another northern on here. Got to the hole and it took a big run. Nope, another bass. They're getting some dandies today.
Must be pushing a couple pounds right there. Beautiful fish.
Beautiful, healthy fish. Got another one on.
Another quality bass, 2-pounder. A bunch of footballs today. Can't believe how many bass I'm catching. Thank you for watching Reservation Outdoors. If you have subscribed to our channel, thank you very much. If not, click the subscribe button. Click the notification button to receive notifications when we upload new videos. Be safe on the ice and take a kid fishing.